and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to our service this morning. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord of creation, whose glory is around and within us, open our eyes to your wonders, that we may serve you with reverence, and know your peace at our life's end. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
To Jezreel, son of Shalatiel, governor of Judea, and to Joshua, son of Jehezobah, the high priest. Thus says the Lord of hosts, these people say the time has not yet come to rebuild the Lord's house. Then the word of the Lord came by the prophet Haggai, saying, is it a time for you yourselves to live in your panelled houses, while this house lies in ruins? Now therefore, thus says the Lord of hosts, consider how you have fared. You have sown much and harvested little. You eat, but you never have enough. You drink, but you never have your fill. You clothe yourselves, but no one is warm. And you that earn wages to put them into a bag of holes. Thus says the Lord of hosts, consider how you have failed. Go up to the hills and bring wood and build the house, so that I may take pleasure in it and be honoured, says the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Response to the psalm is, sound praises to the Lord, all the earth. Sound praises to the Lord, all the earth. Alleluia. O sing to the Lord a new song. Sing his praise in the congregation of the faithful. Let Israel rejoice in their Maker. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their King. Sound praises to the Lord, all the earth. Let them praise his name in the dance. Let them sing praise to him with timbrel and lyre. For the Lord has pleasure in his people and adorns the poor with salvation. Let the faithful be joy in glory. Let them rejoice in their ranks. Sound praises to the Lord, all the earth. Alleluia, alleluia. Speak, Lord, your servant is listening. You have the words of eternal life.
Amen.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now Herod, the ruler, heard about all that had taken place, and he was perplexed, because it was said by some that John had been raised from the dead, by some that Elijah had appeared, and by others that one of the ancient prophets had arisen. Herod said, John, I beheaded, but who is this about whom I hear such things? And he tried to see him. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated for a moment. In today's first reading, the prophet Haggai speaks about rebuilding the great temple of Jerusalem. And one thing that the temple was not used for was to bury the dead. This would have been unthinkable, as there was still fear of the dead bodies, which would contaminate those who walk over their graves. Christian churches are different. But what changed? What changed was the resurrection. The resurrection was not a return to life, but rather a rising into a new kind of life, a life greater and more fulfilled than our own. In today's Gospel, Herod sees John the Baptist as one who has come back from the dead, and this fills him with fear. In many other cultures, there is a fear of death, because the dead are seen as jealous of the living. As Christians, we see things differently. We seek the life of the world to come, and the dead are those whom we pray for, so that they may complete that journey into life. If their souls enter heaven, then they are there to be welcomed and to welcome us into that greater life, so that together we may rise with them into the fullness of life, which is both bodily and spiritual. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, inspire and strengthen the Church to speak out against injustice. Give to all Christian people the grace to endure when their faith is tested, and always to bear witness to the truth. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide all those in authority, that their power may not be abused, and that the innocent may not suffer. Give all in positions of power and influence the desire to seek the common good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the sick in mind or body. May all who work to bring healing and wholeness be given the compassion and skills that they need. We pray especially for those who we know are sick or suffering at this time, praying by name for Mary Reeves, Joan Thorburn, Michael, Nancy Doherty, and Sheila Upperman, and in the silence of our hearts, any others in need of our prayers today. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And we pray for those who have toiled in this world and are now at rest in your kingdom. Among the recently departed, we pray for the repose of the soul of Brian Henderson. And among those whose memory is treasured, especially at this time, we pray by name for George William Neave, William Robson, Jim Thorburn, Alma Staples, Muriel Eileen Lamb, Norman McKellen, Susan Harris, Mary Hilburn, John Thomas McKenna, Dick Blackwood, and Irene Palmer. May they rest in peace
and rise in glory.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And in a moment of silent prayer, we bring before God our own needs and concerns. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Please stand if you're able for the peace. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. And the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.